But, you know, nice to have the Omni-Knight there to provide that kind of free access BKB, I'm sure, for Virtus Pro.
Agree on that one. Lion, I guess they picked it because of Omni-Knight and to control Luna. So far, they needed some control in the game, and that's their control hero. Banned Dragon Knight because we know what no one can do with it, and Dragon Knight, it's really good against Nyx because of his high armor. So
it's also that like five-man style where you have Luna, Dragon Knight, you five-man, you group up, you take towers. That's kind of what VP perfected on the old patch, where they would just end games in 25 minutes because they just get, if they win the laning stage, the game's over from
yes.
there.
Now an Earth Spirit's going to be coming out as kind of their action man, if you will, in the early game. And just a formidable aggressive pick here. I mean, does this have any more tell to their lineup? You were saying that maybe they'd be banking on kind of a five-man. I don't know Earth Spirit to be a big five-man kind of a hero, but maybe it's just a more making an initial impact in the early game.
It's the like hero to win them the lane so that they can five-man later on. It does tell now that Omni-Knight's most likely going to be Pashas here for the offlane. And
yeah.
I think VP, sometimes when they struggled, where teams figured out that Lil, like his hero pool, like sometimes he'd play very greedy kind of full-position heroes. Mm-hmm. But that's where the Earth Spirit doesn't really isn't that greedy hero. That's a hero that can have a more high-impact early game in the laning stage, so I think this is what VP kind of need to go back to in this tournament.
As I said, they need something to combine Nyx with, that's why they picked it, so it's going to be a Nyx Assassin with Lifestealer Bomb, so that's for the Nyx pick. I don't know. As the game goes, I guess it's good to go for a Blink Dagger, so you can just position yourself and try to get an Omni-Knight and just insta-kill him. As for Earth Spirit, they needed an initiation hero for VP side, besides Rubick. And I guess that seals the deal for them.
Now we're at those two mid heroes. I mean, Elements have to pick first. Is there anything that you think is going to stand out for them? Any kind of safe picks that they go to since VP get the counter pick here with last pick?
Well, you mentioned a bit of Storm Spirit before. I had seen Gogi in the past pick it up. But as far as that, any other formidable mid laners that are going to have to match up here? Obviously, they would love to be able to have the last pick mid, but it is going to be Virtus Pro.
Hey, it's going to be a hero for Cole since Gogi switched to position
oh,
five.
You're right.
Yes.
Thank you for that.
Anytime.
But, yeah, well then what's a Cole hero? You hear Cole. What is he playing?
Cole likes like to play Invoker, likes to play Puck. I don't know if he plays Storm. He wasn't in the team back then. So, Invoker could go good for them here.
Invoker, though, I mean, when I see Earth Spirit play, you know, obviously you're looking to make it that initial impact early on. You're looking to gank the mid laner. Invoker does have a bit of a hard time trying to get away if Earth Spirit is able to get a good lead in and a roll. Yeah.
The worry is also, like, you pick Invoker, then VP's just like, all right, we'll take, like, a TA or something and win the mid lane. You've got Ancients to farm. There's a lot you can play against the Invoker.
After banning that Ember Spirit here, it's on them now to kind of make the decision. You got to get someone who should be able to hold their own, given that the counter pick is going to be there and available. They're going to go right in for the Shadow Fiend here, and then it's not take long at all.
I think they want TA regardless of what Elements pick. The TA was just seemed to fit their draft, give them some good like burst damage, physical. The Luna doesn't necessarily burst people down too well, but the TA kind of provides them that.
All right, gentlemen, now that we have the draft before us, it's prediction time. Because what do you think? Based on the draft, who do you think's taking it?
Based on the draft and overall, I think Virtus Pro got this one.
Oh, yeah, I quite like Element's draft. I don't think VP have like heavily after them, but I think VP is just a scary team to be versing right now. So, I have to agree with VP.
All right, well, this is going to be our first match of Dota Pit Season 5. Should be a hype one. Let's go ahead and throw it over to our casters right now. It's going to be Toby Wan and Fogged.
Thank you very much, Dakota. We ready? Are we ready for this? I think we're ready for some Luna Rubick. I'm hoping we're ready for all of this as we'll be pumped in just a moment to the stadium. As, yes, we're going to get underway for game number one. Elements off to a decent draft. They are definitely not, like, I'd say they're not behind the eight ball with the draft. Everything seems pretty even, though we were predicting VP's draft and it was very much this.
Yeah, I mean, the drafts are not like super one-sided or anything. The big ones is just the matchups. You know, the lane matchup mid is the TA versus the Shadow Fiend with an Earth Spirit running in, but there's an Ogre who can kind of match up follow the Earth Spirit's movements and do that. And he has to just do a... It's really going to be really dependent on where this Ogre... what this Ogre does with his time in the first few minutes, because he has to secure mid, and he has to make sure that this Nyx is able to get something in the offlane, because Nyx started with a poor man's shield, so he is not going to ideally want to jungle.
Yeah, and, but they had no other option, right? Like, when we're looking at the drafts, like, well, Darkseer got taken out in the second phase, you don't really have much of another choice. Like, if you can get him up to level 6, then fantastic, but... interesting to see just how heavy the rotations are from Lil on this Earth Spirit, how much he messes around with the lanes, and also how much he does the pull, because I know he likes to do this little dire kick pull down on the bottom lane. So that's another option he can go for.
Yeah, it's really easy actually to pull that camp. You can even do it with other heroes. I mean, if there's any ranged hero, the Satyrs or the Trolls, you can pull that camp to the offlane with anybody. It's extremely easy. I think he's... not really what was intended for that camp, but it is very strong. LeBron going for a level 1 smoke courier snipe.
Yeah, this is... it could be pretty big if he can pull it off, just because it's going to lay up no one's bottle. But Lil's already looking for a kill, so he's going to roll himself forward, looking for that kill on the SF. The distance is too much, but this courier snipe is still waiting. Does he have enough damage with
he's
the boots? He should be able to. Yep, there's two hits, and say goodbye to Virtus Pro's courier early on.
Clever little strat that he's doing. Instead of emphasizing on helping the top or mid lane right away, he's doing it in an indirect manner by taking out the courier. I like that. We did hear from a couple of people here as well that the Elements does have some cheeky little strategies that they have prepared for this tournament. So we'll see if it does come to fruition as this progresses. Because that
well, it's the thing you always look for, right, from the underdog. Yeah. It's that, well, you may not have that much information about it. You've got no experience really playing up against us. So, well, get used to it, guys. We're going to come up with something new, something different. And if you catch them unawares, then surprise upsets are always possible. And Virtus Pro, they haven't looked really strong on this patch, but they definitely looked a hell of a lot better at nearing the end of ESL 1 Genting. But at the start of it, they looked very rusty.
Yeah. They've got some heroes that allow them to make some mistakes and stuff, though, with the Luna, with the Rubick, and with Omni Knight versus this dual lane. Since the Ogre's going to be running around, Omni's going to get a pretty free lane down there just to get his levels, which are much needed in this game. No one getting pressured a bit by LeBron, as expected. He's focusing a lot more on the mid lane than I thought he would. I thought he'd actually go toward top a bit more to help out Mitch, but they put the side wards to at least help him have that avenue to the jungle as well.
He might also be giving a lot of respect to No One. No One is one of the greatest mid players in the game right now. And even with that harassment, he's still completely out CSing the SF. 11-5 up against 5-3. The STA has the advantage from Refraction early on. SF takes a while to build up these souls, but at the same time, like, you still be expecting a little bit more out from the SF.
And this is going to hurt Elements so much. The offlane pull that Lil already did. He pulled the troll once with a roll with the auto attack on him. So he's already almost level 3. And
now they've got a 3-man gank in mid with LeBron as well as Cole up a long way. They start with Solo just throwing back the SF, but Lil actually misses the roll. The kick will be off target as well. Solo still got that Feybolt level 1, but they don't have enough damage to kill off the SF. So the gank will fail with a big miscommunication, and
he should still go down. They still have another roll. They have Fade Bolt up too. Yeah, Cole's gonna die here for sure.
Yep. One last hit, and Solo will take the first blood.
Definitely some miscoordination there, though, but in the end, it's exactly what they wanted. TA is completely free farming, but it does give a little bit of room to Mitch now in the offlane to get some experience, since the Rubick and Earth Spirit are constantly running around, but Pasha getting very good levels in that offlane because of that pull, as well as just being versus dual lane.
Mitch just hung around way too long, and this is what we're worried about with this real strong defensive lane from Virtus Pro. You need to have more than just an Nyx Assassin up there to survive.
I think it's actually pretty important that he has a side ward in that, so he can play in the aggressive, so he knows when the supports move, because right now, since he has that ward just defending his neutral camps up there, he's not able to see the rotations out from the VP supports. So it even puts more pressure on the Shadow Fiend in the mid lane, too.
Elements need to try and find some kind of way to balance out these lanes a little bit more. They're at least getting some good farm on the Lifestealer, so maybe that's when we look to see just how many levels and how does Mitch get these level 6, so they can start using that Lifestealer and Nyx combo.
Yeah, I think it's okay for Nyx to die like once or twice in that top lane, but he doesn't want to do too much because he is getting good levels, so he doesn't want to give too much to supports. Solo stealing the enemy bounty rune and making a rotation toward mid. Cole sitting quite low, and his bottle's empty.
Yeah, he might be thinking about doing a bottle run, but it's a little too late for that.
Picks up a haste around the TA in the top lane, and he's going in.
Well, Cole's low enough, so yeah, No One with 3 points up in Refraction actually uses the deny on the melee creep to get the first bit of side blade damage onto the SF, and it's a very quick, easy two hits after that. And the Shadow Fiend is toast. This is a real, real trouble zone for the SF.
Yeah. They already had the sentry down in the mid lane, too, for the TA when he gets six for the traps, but doesn't need it. Just uses his haste rune, and they do even put a scan down so they know that somebody else is in the vicinity of the mid lane other than the Shadow Fiend. And Lil is just running around, deciding if where he wants to make the next aggressive move.
Yeah. And that's the danger zone I'm looking at right now. Like, the SF, like, what do you want to do? You think about recovery. You think about the stacks, which is already being prepared by LeBron. That's going to be fantastic if only you could really claim it. When Lil's doing heavy rotations on the Earth Spirit, it's never a safe bet that there's not a ward watching you from Virtus Pro.
Or a trap. Like, once he's about to hit six now, he's going to start putting the traps down. They're probably going to recognize that the recovery method for the Shadow Fiend is stacked, so we'll see them do that. But Lil, now, oh, nice play.
Gets the stun over on Goggy and then just rolls to the other side of the river. And there's nothing a Lion can do about that unless he comes in and starts with a Hex. But we are walking around at nighttime, so we probably didn't have that much information before it happened.
Yep. Looking like a nice, clean early game from VP so far. Being on the aggressive in every situation except for that one. Courier Snipe.
Yeah, that timing is going to be really nice as well. Like, the fact that Ramses has been really unhindered in his farm. A lot of denies on either side as well. So the offlane is also having a hard time. Mitch has managed to hit level 5.
He's doing good for himself. Level 5 on a Nyx who can't really go jungle. He didn't get offlane pulls or anything like that. He didn't have the Ogre up there at all. That's pretty damn decent. He should be happy with that. Because Pasha, he's a little bit more ahead of him, but he does have Arcane Boots. So that's the big difference, is the farm.
And he is almost a level in front. So if Virtus Pro does decide to just group up and start forcing down lanes, I'm wondering if there's actually enough to push back. And is there even a desire to do that from Virtus Pro? Like, is there any kind of advantage to creating a five-man push or keeping the status quo?
I think they can just keep it as is. They'll probably do it until Luna takes the top tower. I think that's probably the best play. Because then they can kind of read the movements of the Nyx. If the top lane's constantly pushing in and Nyx isn't there, you're like, okay, well, Nyx is going to be making a play when he hits a 6. Mm-hmm. Just have sentries in the other two lanes. It should be okay.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Farming some ancients now, trying to accelerate his farm a bit more.
Mitch really wants to stay as close to this lane as possible without dying. And he's half a level away from level 6. Picks up the raindrops, which will give him a little bit more protection against the magical burst damage that does arrive from the lane. And they're bringing up Ogre Magi as well now. So a little bit more support. Try and hold this tier 1 tower as long as possible. But it's taking a hell of a lot of damage.
Yeah. VP doing just straight efficiency right now. SF, they know he's going to get some space in the mid lane. The supports are kind of missing, so they don't want to risk no one's life. So he's just stacking ancients, clearing that. Lil as well stacked the other ancients too, so he's got both of those. And it frees up the mid lane so that the Earth Spirit can get the much needed levels that he needs, since he has kind of just been running around and being a nuisance.
Alright, so this maneuver, this seems to be wasting a little bit more time right now. Like, Goggy and LeBron, they're hoping for something to happen. But what are you going to do? Like, Mitch goes for the initial stun, then you walk in?
I'm just hoping for a counterplay.
But no one's there yet.
Yeah, nobody just yet. Earth Spirit's showing mid. They know Templar Assassin. They should know the Templar Assassin's jungling. And, yeah, Pasha's showing in the bottom lane.
Yeah, but with this, like, okay, SF went to go farm the jungle. Now Lil's getting free farm at the mid. See, Earth Spirit's getting a lot more. There's no use of smoke early on either from elements. Sticking with the Lion as well as the Ogre, you'd want to be rotating a lot faster with these guys, especially as both of them have already picked up boots.
Do either of them, none of them even have a smoke on them. Oh, so they didn't even buy one to get the timer started, so they still should have three in stock. Oh no, he used one at the start, that's right, to snap the courier. So they have, the next one should be coming up soon, so they'll have three. And VP as well. So both teams not looking to smoke, and this is where Pasha makes his move. He's got basically level 7. They want to secure this top lane to open up their map movement and limit Mitch's in a way.
Yep. And Mitch is just hiding behind the tower, and there is no counterplay to be had here. Bringing in the Omni Knight is just too much of a force that, well, elements rightly so don't fight this.
Yeah, it's hard for them to really defend any of these tier 1s because they have an okay teamfight lineup when Shadowfiend starts getting online, but before that, they have nothing to deep push. They literally have like no spam. It's pretty much Shadowfiend raises, which is not what that hero is there for, so that's not his job. So the tier 1s are going to be extremely difficult for them to really defend versus VP's lineup.
Mitch is going to finally TP out, and I was wondering how long this would take. The Kree Wave on the bottom hasn't pushed out far enough, so he can't just combo with the Lifestealer with Infest straight away. But they know that Lil is down here farming, so there's an opportunity for a kill. But if Mitch starts with his attack, Lil's going to have time to react. And that's his issue, and that's exactly what happens. But no, the kick and the stun is actually all in range, so he's rolling boulders into elements. And they pick off the offlaner.
Lil being a bit greedy there, trying to mooch his level 6. He was I think if he gotten his level 6 from the creep before that, he would have just gotten out of there. But he was, like, I think, like, what, one experience away or something? He's very close to getting that level 6. Nice. But it's just an Earth Spirit kill, but it does accelerate the armlet pickup now for the Lifestealer, and he's going to be building toward SNY, it seems like. So very early mid-game fighting build coming out for the Lifestealer.
What do you think about the Templar Assassins building the Desolator before actually completing a Blink Dagger? Especially in this game for no one, he's already picked up the first Mithril.
I think he doesn't need to really go for those type of plays with the lineup that they have, since they have Luna and Omni Knight. They can just go for pressuring towers, even securing Roshan nice and early. It's very hard for Elements to really fight into that type of lineup with the Repel as well on him. So he has that kind of, like, defensive and aggressive power from it. Solo doing some jungling, trying to get his level 6 on Rubick as well. So everybody's just kind of maximizing efficiency all over this place on this map. Lion showing top, Urspirit showing bottom. Everyone just, there's no really, like, plays that are going to be coming out, and Mitch is even jungling, so.
Yeah, it's a full-on jungle, and you're seeing, like, the result of it. The Courier was completely chockers. I guess bringing Ramsey's Dominator over to him now, and still got the other Mithril Hammer for no one, plus Lil's Tome of Knowledge.
Yep, this is where they start pressuring the Lifestealer's lane, pressure down the safe lane. Just take all the tier 1s when they have all their level 6s, because VP's teamfight versus Elements is much stronger. With the Earth Spirit, with the Luna, with Templar Assassin traps on top of Omni Knight, it's just way more potent. And Rubick has some pretty darn good spells that he can steal in this game, with Lion, with Nyx, easy steals for the stuns, and then of course Requiem from Shadowfiend. Swift Ending does get scouted out. Rage gets stolen. That's a very nice defensive ability for Rubick as well.
Mm-hmm.
Mid lane, this could be where no one gets pressured here.
Yeah, he gets stunned. His Refraction charges it down. He got two bottle charges up his sleeve, but he needs extra help. Pasha's going to be there. Triggers off the Guardian Angel, and no one wants to try and start fighting. With that Sideblade damage, they've got to stop walking in a straight line. They're taking too much extra spill damage. And no one's already got his Refraction up. Now in comes Swiftening. In through the back end. He wants to try and bring down the Omni, but there's just too much damage with Earth Spirit. Turning on the Magnetize. Both Goggy as well as Mish just have to roll out of here, but Lil rolls in right on top of the Lion onto the Eclipse as well. The damage is so heavy from Virtus Pro, and Solo is here to make sure the SF cannot even escape. Ramsey's with a triple kill. This was a fight that was starting on bottom lane with VP pressuring, and they bring every man to the mid, and now they'll take the last tier 1 tower of Elements.
Fighting into VP's lineup is just extremely difficult. No one is already over-leveled, and with the Omni Knight, who's also over-leveled, coming in, just a heal, a repel, Guardian Angel, everything is completely just deterred, and they even claim the bottom tower with that catapult that the Luna had picked up. So that was a nice, like, it was like a perfect crisp rotation for VP. Everything just kind of fell into their laps, it seemed like. Elements were trying to go for an aggressive play, though, which was nice, but great reaction from VP.
Yeah, but this is what you were talking about, right? Like, Elements, is there really a way they can defend their tier 1 towers? Like, where is their counter push when you run an Ogre as well as a Lion?
Yeah.
It just doesn't exist. It comes from the SF, but that puts him in harm's way.
And that's not, I mean, that's never where you really want your SF to be. He's got to just go farm. He's got to get, like, one or two items so he can actually be a force in the game, but at this point, he currently can't. Elements, though, going for a smoke play toward that top lane. Mitch is situated there, and he's showing in the lane. So they know he's not Vendetted, so this could be a little bit of an unexpected approach.
Well, I thought the last buy run for Virtus Pro was a while back, but now there's a Yasha sitting over on the Courier. He's flying out at the moment with also the Urn Recipes, the rest of that for Lil.
Yeah, he's out. Uses the scan, clips somebody with it as well, and just gets the hell out of there.
Rubick's nearby, and with the Observer and Sentry planted down, like, the Nyx can't go for his little
Radiant's
Vendetta run.
I like that too. Solo picked up a bracer, so he's probably going to go for what, like a drum. But having that little that bracer lets you not be able to get Solo picked off by the Nyx Assassin.
So then at least he can react to Mitch.
They see Mitch.
Yeah, they have the sentry. They know he's there. And now all they need to get is Solo to pick him up. The Spike Carapace create a little bit more space. Spike Carapace actually stolen by Solo. Rolling boulder forward. Mitch moved up north. They were hoping it actually run close towards the other sentry ward. Mitch is very lucky. He'll end up surviving. Not enough damage from the Magnetize.
Lucky that Lil ran out of stones, because it seemed like Lil had an idea of which direction he went. But yeah, no stones to extend the Magnetize and actually pick up a kill. So Mitch making a little bit of space for his Shadow Fiend, for his Lifestealer, at least during that, with that move. Doesn't get a kill, but space.
At the same time, space is created on bottom lane. Ramsey's and Pasha are teaming up. They've already brought the tower down by a quarter of its life, and a lot of support is rotating down by VP. Again, they want to fight. Guardian Angel is up. They have basically everything they want, including potentially a kill onto Mitch, if Solo can get the grab. No Spire Carapace up, so no one. Oh, he'll have to take the one last hit. Can he get a Sideblade to strike? No, he can't. Mitch went inside the Invis and away to safety. Lil went for his little play as well, but can't find the target.
They're completely on the defensive, though. They're not able to dictate the pace of the game at all. It's all VP making every single aggressive move. They do get a tower picked up by Swift ending in the top lane, but losing a tower bottom now, the whole entire jungle access is VP's now on for the Radiant side.
Yeah, and VP would just keep going with it. Like, take the tier 2 tower out, move all the outer towers. It's just very efficient, and this is the style of Dota which you and the position of Dota you really want to be in this current patch, because this opens up shrines. This opens up everything.
I mean, versus the Shadow Fiend too. Like, Shadow Fiend is now basically has nowhere to farm because he doesn't want to go play in the aggressive side, aggressive opposite side of the map, and his entire jungle and his side of the map is completely contested.
And you actually see the wards up from Virtus Pro. So these went down for the Nyx Assassin, but they're going to have serve a double purpose. Is if SF does do what he's now doing, he's going to get scouted out. So they potentially could have seen the animation of the raise. Okay, but VP doesn't care. They're already going to go for the pit.
Yeah, go for the rush. Oh, they actually fake it out. Go for a smoke.
Yeah, they saw the SF coming from the north.
Yeah, that haste rune being popped. Elements also popping a smoke on the rest of theirs. And I think the smoke's actually spotted by that one of the ops wards in the mid lane. They did get a sentry down, so they know that one ward is there, but I believe Virtus Pro knows something is up.
Yeah, they just pinged
it on the high ground.
They just pinged it and changed the wards over from solo stash. Maybe not that great. He put down the observer ward. He got the secondary sentry, so he saw Mish for a moment, pick up the lifestealer, throw him back in.
Oh,
no one. Oh, with the kick as well. So much damage. No one is going to tear apart this element's lineup. A double kill for him. Even Rubick stealing Infest, so he jumps inside the Templar Assassin. Just in case TA wants to go for a jump of her own. But this is now going to be an uncontested Roshan for Virtus Pro.
That was weird. They didn't even infest the Nyx like, to try to like go for that type of initiation play. He just was running in as a lifestealer. He gets picked up instantly by Solo. Beautiful silence from Lil from the Geomantic Grip. And Geomagnetic Grip. Hard one to say sometimes. And a nice three-man stun right afterwards. But yeah, just VP seeming to know everything that's going on from Elements. And Elements unable to really get any ground in this game.
It's going to be a hard thing for them to pull back as well. The change in Ramsey's creep, so obviously he dropped out the Centaur, but picks up the Ogre Frostmates. Now everyone's going to have extra armor as well, harder to attack in. This SF, who's like no BKB coming anytime soon for him. He's only just got this basic Dragon Lance, and his next major item he's looking at is a Shadow Blade. Suppose he needed something which would allow him to initiate.
I don't even know about that though. The Shadow. Okay, I can understand why, but you're having Nyx on your team, and they are very keen on having sentry wards on two or three heroes on VP. Wouldn't be surprised if we see them pick them up a gem, even very very shortly. Take out the shrines, take a gem, and then that could be their avenue to go to the high ground. But they're not even waiting.
It's fight time. Like, he actually needs Nyx to fight right now. TP back, maybe just have all of the buyback. But this tier 3 tower, okay, while LeBron didn't survive long, Ogre is meant to be one of the tankiest support heroes in the game. But when you're running a Templar Assassin with that much negative armor effect, it's hard to survive even now. Swiftening trying doing his work on the front lines, but Lil jumps in the bank and everyone gets magnetized, silenced up. They're trying to run in deep, and remember, no one's got a license to dive at the moment because he has that Aegis the Immortal, plus he's actually got the Omni-Knight behind him. So with the extra heals, they try and follow. Silo finally pops back out again, the infestation, picking up Mitch, just delaying up a little bit. Lil, they'll finger him down. Finally, they get that kill, but Ramsey turns the ulti on, and it's going to be a solo SF ulti almost onto him, can turn his attention towards Mitch. Loser beams off cooldown right now, but it's not enough damage to find that kill, but it won't matter. No one's still on a bit of a rampage, and they call it 18-minute GG call coming out from Elements. Virtus Pro looking strong and looking very much in control.
The Omni-Knight pick completely dismantled everything that they could actually do in the fights. Even though they could try, the Repel just thrown at somebody, they can just dive in as far as possible, and just with the lead that they have, everything they did was on point. They just dictated the entire pace of the game, and they picked a very strong lineup that wins lanes.
Yep, absolutely wonderful performance from Virtus Pro, and not really showing that weakness they had in their first games at ESL 1. Elements, like, we still ask the question though, like, they had a couple of interesting concepts, but they never really pushed any of these things to happen.
They're versus Rubick Luna in the first two as well, and they picked themselves no D push, so I think that's actually very hard for them to really just play, because without defending your tier ones, you kind of have to stall out, giving up a couple too many kills in the laning phase too, just let them to this potential, into this position where they just couldn't really do anything. VP just ran at them.
Well, we'll see if Elements can create a little bit more space, so stay tuned. We will be back for game number 2. Will Virtus Pro make it a clean wipe, or will Elements force us into a third? We'll find out after the break.